Brendan. I am 16 and a sophomore in high school, or as you guys say in England, I'm in year 10. And I started my motivational speaking career in April of this year. And it didn't really start as something that I could imagine it would be. What happened was there was this event going on called TEDxRBA, which is a local TED organized event that was going on in my city. So I was really fascinated by this, and I was in the process of being nominated for a spot in the event. So turns out that after going through a few weeks of interviews with the team organizing it, they selected me to be a speaker at the 2015 event, and that's kind of how my career started. And it's really amazing how it's taken off the way that it has, because I'm now able to go around to so many different groups of all ages, from businessmen to middle school age kids and everywhere in between, to give them inspiring and motivating talks, to have them encouraged to follow their dreams or be unstoppable, and all different types of things that I like to incorporate when I give my talks. I learned at a young age that I can't change who God made me. This is what I'm gonna have for the rest of my life. And, you know, there's really nothing that I could do to alter it or to make it any better. So I learned that I need to accept myself in order for others to accept me. And to be honest, that was really hard, because I've always wanted to fit in with everyone. I always wanted to be a normal looking kid who could do sports and who could play football and soccer and everything that normal kids and teenagers could do, but I could never really do that. So I really think that if one cannot change the things that they don't like, embrace the other things that you have. So what I don't have physically, I am like 7 feet tall right here and right here. So I was not blessed with height, but I was blessed with the ability to have what I do have, and I'm just very, very lucky to have that. I unfortunately have pain in my knees and my hips, so it causes me a lot of trouble to walk, and that's been getting worse and worse as I've been getting older. Whenever I go somewhere, I usually just try to be as respectful and calm as I can be, to try not to encourage people to make fun of me or to take pictures, because that happens a lot. Usually with kids and teenagers who you say, oh, that kid's so funny looking, I'm gonna post this on Twitter, I'm gonna post this on Instagram. So I think that it just really depends on where I am and what type of situation I'm in, but the responses that I usually get are pretty nice. I do a variety of talks in different places, so anywhere from schools to these large corporations to business people, and I really just love to inspire as many people as I can. So I really don't care what the audience size is, because I go from 10 people to over 1,000 people. It really doesn't change much for me, to be honest, because I always get the same response from the audience, that I've helped them so much, I've made them smile, I've made them rethink what they want to do, and so it gives me the best feeling, being able to know that I'm making a difference in people's lives. I have been bullied all throughout my school career, from elementary school to right now in high school, and that varies from just having people not want to be friends with me and talk to me to getting death threats online. I just think that me being me and me having this very unique opportunity has been my own motivator to get people to look at me in a different light and get people to see that I'm not just this 3'8", 16-year-old. I am so much more than that.